Jay Matt is not your everyday lunch partner. He's all the way raw.
How are you going to say Black Lives Matter when the only reason you come out is when cops kill us and we don't come out when we kill ourselves? That's crazy, man.
He's all the way real.
The truth? You can't even handle the truth.
And most of all, he has his priorities right.
I want the Falcons and the Hawks to be my pallbearers at my funeral. That way they can let me down just one last time.
Jay Matt gives it to you big.
Holla at your boy. Life after the caliber. Jay Matt, you heard me? We out here on all social media platforms. So if you look good, feel good, and if you smell good,
you do what you want, put a hump in your back, then lift your rump. In the club with a pump, won't fit in the trunk. You better run for it like you Forrest Gump. Back it up on his rock hard bone. Who's taking your baby mama home? I'm here to pump the party for show. Girl, catch the ball or you can rock the boat. Matter of fact, you can do both. Oh, shaking like a dog.
That's right. You're listening to your boy Jay Mad on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify. And all the other platforms that we're on, even Alexa. Alexa can make it do what it do. We going live, y'all. We got Miss Jackie is in the house. Michelle is in the house. Good to have you on the show. Don't even go there. See this. We already finna get into a problem right now. Don't even do it, Philly. Don't even do it. Michelle, what's going on with you? Jackie, what's going on with you? Gina, what's going on with you? Hey, Gina, the gentleman, 7 Mill, is the one that wrote that from New Orleans. So that's the new intro to you look like you need to tell somebody something. You need to tell, look, go ahead and tell, go ahead. No, go and get it. Don't get it out your system, man.
I'm good, bro.
Finish saying your hellos. Miss Jackie, good to have you. Michelle, what's going on with you? I have so many people popping up here on Facebook Live Portraits. All of y'all. Lorenzo, what's going on, big dog? Hamburger, what's going on with you, man? Appreciate y'all joining in. Everybody that I missed over here on Facebook Live, I'm sorry. The names went up so quick, I couldn't see all the people just started jumping on. Wait a minute. Okay, I'm offended right now. I just got offended. Y'all ain't never jumped. I advertised that this dude, I ain't even going to introduce him yet. I advertised that this dude is going to be on the show. And everybody want to be on the show. The numbers done went up over here. That's my buddy Chuck. I'm finna cut. We finna end the show. Thank y'all so much for joining me on Life After the Collar tonight. I appreciate y'all. I hope you all have a great Memorial Day weekend.
Thank y'all for coming out. God bless you.
Good night. That part right there. Y'all playing. Jackie. So his mouth is itching to tell you, hey. When we sat there and I told when we spoke and he talking about some hey Jackie, and we ain't even on air. Let me go ahead and do this. I got my boy in the house. Chuck Taylor is in the house. I call him Philly. He's a bona fide chef. The Joker could cook his tail off when we do our little things over at the Cigar Lounge, and he does his cooking thing outside or inside, whichever way he decided to be. He sells out every time. You got to get there early. He was. See, Jackie finna get blocked tonight. Jackie is about to get blocked tonight, Philly. Hey, Chuck. Go ahead and tell her hey.
Hey, big head.
See, that right there. That's how fights get started. So, let me tell y'all about my dude Chuck. I don't have a lot of friends. I don't hang around. I know y'all sit there like, dang, as handsome as you are, and as funny as you are, and you know, I know you got a plethora of friends. I've been using that word all week, Doc.
And you've been using it wrong.
It means a lot.
Plethora, not plethora.
Plethora.
That sounds like some fake leather. Plethora.
Jackie talking about some hey, big head. We ain't doing this. I'm telling y'all. I'm telling both of y'all. We're not doing this tonight. We're not. A lie don't care who tell it, long as it get told. So I got my boy Chuck in the house with me in the studio. Hey, Chuck, tell me what you think of the studio, man.
This what you've been doing with your quarantine time.
Chuck was like, I took Chuck outside and showed him what we were doing in the backyard and stuff like that. He said, y'all just out here just doing stuff. Y'all, we're going to have a great conversation tonight. Here's what we're going to do. Here's the topic of tonight. Y'all saw me. I put, look, talk trash now. That's the name of the thing. I got my bag up with me now. So we're going to talk about whatever y'all want to talk about, and I got my bag up with me. Sonya, what's going on, dear? What's up, man?
Can we cuss?
Okay. Put all of y'all children to bed. All the kids got to go to bed tonight. All the kids got to go to bed tonight. Because here's why. Ain't no telling. He put it on the post. Ain't no telling what is going to come out tonight. One reason I roll with this dude is because he keeps it 100 all the time. He keeps it 100 all the time. So he's just not going to act right. At all. Who ain't going to act? Wait. Who are you talking about, Jay Latrina? That's a girl from... Gray and loving it. Oh, see. Yeah. So here's the thing. Make sure you have your red cup. You have to have your red cup. If you're going to do this, you got to have your red cup or your bottle in your hand. I ran out of red cups. I got a clear glass. I said that last Friday, didn't I, y'all? And I didn't go get any. My bad. I knew, hey, Jay Latrina, I knew you was going to come back and say that. I knew she was going to come back and say that when I said, that's old girl. So she was like, wait, old girl. I knew you was going to come back and say it. So y'all, get back, sit back, relax, enjoy yourselves. We get ready to go live on this thing, and we're going to talk about whatever y'all want to talk about. Since my boy's in the house, I'm going to play his favorite song. I'm not playing Whitney Houston. Is this show going to be...
I'm going to turn all this
show. No, I wanted to find a show that had something to do with Philly. Because my boy's from Philly, so I just had to play him a Philly song. Holler at your boy. It's all good. It's all gravy.
like shining ones. You know the mentality. Keep flipping the gift.
My spotlight is on us now. Watch us do this. Live and direct from Philly Town.
Rap and hype and we can get down.
We are ready to roll. So now the world will know that we love.
One day back in Philly, four guys wanted to sing. They came up to me, I said, well, what's your name?
What's the man?
Hey, you know what I'm saying? Then I said, all right, fellas, well, let me see what you can do. And then a smile when they wanted and said, yo, Mike, check this out. See if this one moves you.
You listen to Life After the Collar with your boy J-Mad on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa, that's right, Alexa can make it do what it do. Y'all, we're going to have a great time on the show today. I was doing the bass line, but he jacked me all up. Boom, 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 boom. A, B, C, B, B, D. Mmm. I told y'all, I got it. I need a singing career. Here's what we're going to do. He, y'all see how rude people are? Y'all see, I didn't have anything to do with that. Y'all saw how rude that was. Talking about I got a face for radio. With friends like him, I promise y'all, I don't need any enemy right there. With a Jackie, he said he's from South Philly, where they are hood rats. Live hood rats.
No.
Ain't no you saying ain't no hood rats in South Philly.
Hood rats in South Philly, but South Philly is known for setups. Girls set you up in South Philly.
So
if you ever meet a chick from South Philly, don't never go to her house by yourself.
So if you ever meet, guys, listen to this, if you ever meet a chick from South Philly, don't go by yourself. All right, here's what I want to do. I really want to have a discussion on a plethora of different conversation. Sonya, what he do now? I know I didn't do anything that time. That had to be Philly. We're going to have a talk about some of anything, especially the news and stuff like that. Behind me is my dude who is, he's 100% real. I'll give my life for this dude sitting beside me. He'll do the same. We done found ourselves in situations where we almost kind of... You would give your life for me? See? Y'all, see? See? That part right there. Bad boys for life. Thank you. I appreciate that. As I was saying, I'm trying to give you accolades. What word did I say?
Accolades.
Okay, first of all, you got to understand I'm from the country.
Echo and accu.
What is it? Echo?
Accolades.
This is finna be. This is finna be a long night. Except Paul several times.
You wanted to talk about...
about. Here's what we're gonna talk about, some of everything. We're gonna talk about some of everything, and I want your honest opinion when we talk about these subjects. Most of the people already know my thoughts on these subjects that we bring up. Y'all, I don't know how I'm gonna make it through this show. He's sitting in a bar stool, y'all. Talking about something, you got me sitting. Jackie, please don't get booted out this room. What we gonna talk? I want them to bring up subjects. I really want you all to bring up subjects. Did I say that word right? Mm-hmm. Ask. Did I say that word?
Yeah, don't ask.
You don't ask. You ask.
You ask questions.
I want you all to see, how about that? See, I did go to English 101. I want you all to ask questions that you all have gotten my opinion about, whether it's relationships, let's not ask relationship questions to Philly. Let's not do that. Really good dude.
I got a relationship.
So, the one.
You know one thing that's bad for radio, right?
What's that?
Dead air. Like, you can't stop talking.
No, you're not. But, see, you. Just keep talking. So, my son that comes over to your house. What's his name?
Excuse me?
So, y'all, Philly ready to hit me in the back of the head now. He's
like,
We finna fight.
Oh, that's that bullshit.
We finna fight now.
Okay.
We finna fight now.
Hey, Sammy.
Okay. Gina asked this question. I want you, they know my opinion.
That's my daughter's mom name.
That's your daughter's mom name?
Yeah.
Well, this one is a really good lady. This is my sister.
My daughter's mom, she all right.
I knew Michelle, I knew you was going to ask that question. I'm going to ask Gina questions first. Why do men lie?
Why do women believe it?
Go there with it. So I think y'all can hear me on Facebook. It's clear on Facebook. But can y'all hear Philly over here on Spreaker? He responded the perfect way.
What was your response? The question was, why do men lie?
And I said, why do women believe them?
Why do women believe them? It, go further, because I got kicked out of a group today.
A Facebook group. They kicked you out?
Because I made the very statement that you made. So it was supposed to be a funny post.
And the post was, guys, give your best pickup line. So everybody's giving their little pickup lines or whatever, and it was funny that people was coming out, and I got it. But then this one dude got serious.
Oh, it's always one.
It's always that one.
Because he think if he's the serious one, that all the females
gotta go straight to him. Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, I'm gonna lie to you and have fun.
So he says something about a real man won't do this, that, and the other, and we won't play games. And so I asked the question. I said, why do women fall for these pickup lines? So it was the same
it's
one.
It's the same thing.
It's the same
basically,
thing.
Men lie every day to everybody. Men, if you say, get up and take out the trash, I'm great, do it right now. You don't do it right now. That's a lie.
Gotcha.
You know, after you finish your video game, or after you finish your cigar, or tomorrow. You just might forget, but you just lied to her.
Right.
So, I mean, a lie is a lie. It's like big lies, it's little lies, but they all lies.
So, yeah. I'm like this. That's not a good answer. Who's this? Dr. Shirley. That's not a good answer. He just gave smoke and scream to keep from answering. Okay, I'm going to give you my answer. The reason why men lie, because the thing is, why do men lie, or why do men lie to women? Y'all really don't want to know the truth from us. Let's just go ahead and be honest. Majority of the time, let's go ahead and get this straight. The majority of the time, you all already know the answer. Go.
So this is the disclaimer. I want you to know that whatever he says or whatever I say is my opinion. I don't want him to lose female followers over some shit I did. So go on.
I'm like this. There is no way I can lose out on listeners. I'm going to be me regardless. So now, again, why? Because y'all, the truth, you can't handle the truth. And that's why guys lie. No ifs, no ands, no buts. That's how we perceive it. Whether y'all want the truth or not. Our perception is, if you know the truth, if we tell you the truth, it's going to hurt your feelings. And our desire is not to hurt your feelings.
The dumbest question that females ask men is, do I look fat in this?
Let's go with that question there. Do I look fat in this?
Do you want me to tell you, yes, babe, you look fat. You need to take them off. Or do you want to hear me say, no, you don't look fat. You look good in them.
Well, see, I your response, I get his response, and I appreciate his response, because my thing goes back to this. 90% of the time, if not even more, y'all already know the answer. And instead of coming at men like, hey, I found this out, can you explain? Y'all not going to approach it. So why not ask the question the way it needs to be, make a statement the way it needs to be answered? I found this about you. Can you explain? Doesn't it depend on a specific topic? Look, the truth is the truth, no matter what it is referring to. Why lie? Again, because we don't want to hurt your feelings. That's just our way of thinking. Two reasons. One, we really don't want to hurt your feelings. Two, we really don't want to lose you. Period. Why do guys lie? We don't want. And who is this over here? Michelle said, we all lie. Everybody lie. Well, not everybody. Well, we.
Nigga, everybody.
Lie. Everybody. Yes. At one point in our lives, we all lie. And sometimes even a little white lie is still a lie. There's no such thing. This is either a lie or not a lie. Now you're generalizing the answer. No, the question is, why do men lie? And I'm telling you directly, the reason why men lie is because, one, we're not trying to hurt your feelings. And let me say it a better way. We're sparing. We consider ourselves sparing your feelings. Is that a better way, would you say? And the other reason is, you already know the truth.
I lie to female waitresses all the time.
You lie to female, what do you tell female waitresses?
That they cute, oh my God, you are wearing that apron.
Uh-huh, and why do you do these things?
So I can get what I want. I have been comp meals because of, you know, like, damn girl, you're
kind
of cute. If I wasn't married, I'd take you home.
That part. Well, I'm no. See, Never mind. Don't do that. Don't.
I wouldn't.
Thank you. Ari said that's bull. Men lie to save themselves. No.
I agree with that in some sense.
Well, I think, well, yes. I can see where she's coming with that. Younger guys. Because when we get older and somebody walk up to me and ask me a question, I'm going to play fool like you playing fool. I'm going to be honest with you. I've learned this trait, and people I don't know if this is a good trait or not. If you come and ask me a question that I know you already know the answer to, I'm going to play along with you. I'm going to play the game with you. Since this is a game, let's play the game. If you play stupid games,
you win stupid prizes.
You win stupid prizes. So he gives a false compliment.
Yeah.
Because y'all full of ish, ISH. That's why y'all lie. Let me tell you.
So,
I think you better ask the same thing I wanted to ask.
This shit.
There you go. That's exactly where I was going with it.
So, women lie, if not as much.
They lie better and better. Y'all lie more and better.
Because it's 100,000 men walking around thinking they got the best penis on earth because y'all done lied and faked orgasms, and now he giving bag dick to tons of women.
Doc. See, now y'all don't want to play the game. Everybody want to be quiet now. You ain't nothing moved up here yet. Women lie as much as men, but y'all lie better. Here's why. Because you and your girl already got y'all story together. Mary. You ain't talked to Mary. But Mary know that if I call her and ask, Aries with you? Mary is gonna say, we hung out today.
And she left her jacket in my car.
Tell her
to come get it. Keep leaving shit in my car.
See, y'all, ladies, I want y'all to be honest. I want y'all to be honest. Do women lie? Yes or no? Oh, you made me. I'm finna jump across the line over there, man. Y'all sit there and say, yeah, you made me come.
This what you wanted. You wanted me here. So you knew what type of.
Some women do. Okay. Gina says some women do lie. Not all. Let's flip it then. Some men do lie. Not all. Boom. So not the question is, why do some men lie? Y'all. You and me must never part. Go ahead.
You know, like they say, all men are dogs. Who told you to try them all?
That makes you. That's why I can't hang with you. Because this stuff just jumps out of my mouth. Okay, I would go with that. Oh, okay. Okay. Y'all agree with that? Okay, I'll agree with that. That's what Gina said. Yogi said, I agree with Gina. Not all men lie. And let me go ahead and put this out there since we're here, because this has been tapping my hide, if I could use country term, all week. That means that it's been bothering me all week, Philly.
Oh, okay. I was
it means it's been bothering me all week. So
I shaved my head just for the night.
look good, huh?
No, Philip, we are not doing this. We are not, ladies, don't.
Hey, finish your thoughts.
Something was
bothering you.
Philly talking about something. I done shaved my head, and now my grandmother used to use the word primping. You primping in front of the mirror. He's over here trying. Ladies, totally ignore Philly right now. Hey, Sunday's here yet? Ty, Sunday here yet? I'm spending the night tonight and Saturday night so that I can wake up Sunday and just start eating. I already told you, I'm not eating Saturday. I'm not even going to eat Saturday. I'm going to wake up Sunday and just start eating.
That's real fat.
I'm just going to eat all day Sunday. So here's what's been bothering me. Y'all sit there. There are a lot of women that think that there was this one video that, and I meant to post it on my page. One lady, she was just going off on dudes. She was saying how, men, y'all got the pick of the litter, and ladies, we out here scraping the bottom of the barrel. These men out here ain't nothing but all our women. Y'all get to choose all these good women. Let me tell y'all something right now. All of y'all women that think y'all strong women ain't strong women. All of y'all women out there that think that y'all are good women, y'all really ain't good women. I'm gonna go ahead and be honest with you. And all of these dudes that y'all say y'all that ain't good men or whatever, and she made it very clear. She said, either you got a whole bunch of money and you got your career going on, but you don't look right. Or you got all the looks. No, she said you could throw the D the right way, but you sorry as hell. That's how she put it. Let me tell y'all something. Let me tell y'all something right now. Since we here, Lord Jesus, I don't even know how I jumped all the way over there though. But all of y'all women, all these people thinking that they're y'all, all women out there are good. The hell they are. Gina, yes ma'am, you are a great woman. I told you what Jackie said. I ain't gonna say it on air, but I told you what Jackie said. But let me tell y'all something. Let me tell y'all, stop this foolishness with this conversation that all these dudes out here are bad. They may not look like what you want them to look like.
Oh, they got to be 7'12".
Oh, man.
7 inches of dick.
Man, if I hear...
head with dreads and muscles and tattoos.
If I hear one more 5 foot nothing woman say, I only date 6 feet and above. You... Man, look at here. You got me. Look. Look now. Doggone it. Sometimes you attract what you put out. You better believe it. Wanda, you said. You stupid. Y'all didn't hear what he said, but I did. Wanda, you're right. Wanda said sometimes you attract what you put out. The reason why y'all are let me go. Okay, see. The reason why, ladies, the reason why y'all attracting certain type of men, that's the type of energy that you're putting out. You're on these social media pages and showing all your ass. And guess what we want now? I hear people say all the time, I saw one lady, she said, I had to stop blocking these dudes for getting in my inbox. Well, all you showing is your ass your butt. Well, I said it now. All you doing is showing your butt, your ass on Facebook.
Come on, use your words. Be wrong.
And now you mad because these dudes are jumping in your inbox or responding a certain way and sending you dick pics. Because that's how you have presented yourself. Let's just be honest, ladies. And then let me get on. Can I talk to the church girls?
Talk to them.
Let me tell y'all about y'all church girls.
Woo-hoo, they are the.
Y'all put up these sexy pictures. Y'all like these ain't sexy pictures? Yes, they are. And y'all know what y'all doing. I don't care what nobody say. Some of these pictures are. Philly is behind me going in on church girl.
Ooh, she loves TikTok.
Shut up, Philly. So, I done seen so many pictures. I mean, I'm talking about sexy pictures. Not that they go over the line. I'm not saying that they, you know, showing breasts and then say, God bless me. I'm not talking about, I'm talking about these women that's out here. And you know you got, your body is what it is. You know, you're right. You don't have to be ashamed of your body. No, y'all don't need to hear everything Philly is saying. Y'all really don't. Y'all really don't. That's exactly, because he said, hey man, all I need is a mic. Philly, did I even think about giving you a mic tonight? Mm-mm. I said, move your chair over there. That way he'll be closer to this mic.
Mm-hmm. Two temps, one mic. I am David Ruffin, and these are the two temps.
You're listening to Life After the College with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify. Whoever that was, I think that was Michelle, maybe, that asked a question about 45. We're going to get back. When we come back, we're going to come back on that conversation right there. I am interested to hear what he has to say about this dude. Holla at you, boys. All good.
Y'all know what this is. My mind was changed. I'm glad you made it. Intoxicated, your vibe's amazing. Feel the love in the air, baby, you know. In a rush, you've been at it where the time goes. You gonna just show me now, cause I done had one too many drinks. And I know that you feel me the way I've been feeling you. And it's cool that you got a motive, and I think I like it. I know all your be timid when you win it, better lay red. I know you wanna go there. I see it, step front and come back. I know you can drive it, chauffeur. Anticipate your touchdown. Come put me down like right now. Let's be lovers and friends. Let's rendezvous. Boy, I got plans for you. Cause I'm motivated. I'm yours for the taking. No further.
Somebody and you know you want their body, gone. Let them hear you say it loud.
Boy, it's about to go down. Yo, what you saying? Come and show me now. Feel as if you with somebody and you know you want that body, then let me hear you say it loud.
Good love, no question. Reach out and you touch me. I have it, don't judge me. Just don't waste my time. Loving, no questions. Reach out and you touch me.
Don't
touch me, just
don't waste my time. No, 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 no. Just don't waste my time.
I'm gonna go here with it. You're listening to Life After the College with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do. We got Philly in the house tonight. He is hanging out. Jackie told me to give you the mic. Look, I'm trying to save my show. I am not giving him the whole mic. Ty over here getting it in. If you're not on Facebook Live, Ty is over here getting it in. She said, cover the up. I got a body.
Don't cover up.
I got...
Why would she want him to cover up?
Because they married. So, Ty... If
they don't respect their marriage, why the hell should I?
Say it loud and proud. Say it loud and proud.
I said, if they don't respect their marriage, why the hell should I?
Earlier, Ty said this. Let me get back to it. Where is it? Did I pass it? Here it is. I've seen married ones on my timeline showing camel toe and all, and then getting attitude when a man... and get mad when a man jump in her inbox. Y'all gonna stop that foolishness. So Philly gonna be on your page from now on now. Yeah, that's hey Ty. That's so Ty's my sister, and she that girl right there is the truth. I got some ladies that's around me that hang out that gives me the doggone truth every single time. See, the dummy over on the other side, he don't say nothing. He just sit there with his hand on his chin like this.
But this dummy,
this here, dummy right here just say whatever pops in his head. So, we got to get to a place. We have to get to a place. When we say, so the original, what's up, Pat? What's good with you, Doc? You could have asked your boy to come over. Man, you know you always welcome. Matter of fact, I'll light the grill and everything. So now you feel like Philly felt when I went over Philly over Pat house. See, Tina, you done jumped. She said, Ty said she like you. When you said she cute.
Oh, she heard that.
She heard that. Oh, Lord Jesus.
I smoke too. Paradise tomorrow, 11 o'clock.
You know, Ty is, she's an ambassador. What cigar, the ambassador you cigar you with?
Arizona.
Is that what it is?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you a real stalker.
No, she came into the shop. I know who she is.
But you a real stalker. Pat, come on over, big dog. Matter of fact, I'll do a whole show with you not Monday. Come over.
He the last person people want to see.
Yeah, you right now, you the last person people want to see right now. Because usually you are the last person people see. Shout out to, so we have a lot of, you ain't.
You got a plethora. There you go.
I have a plethora of friends on here. Check this out. Jakarta, what's going on with you? Let me give a shout out. I try to do this on all of my shows. Let me give a shout out to all of the essential workers. Jakarta is one. Aries is one. Wanda is one. And I have never mentioned his name. Patrick Bugs is also another one. Let me tell y'all what he does. He is a mortician. Did I say that word right? He's a mortician, and he is. They work that industry there.
Wait, say it again.
Mortician.
No, more.
Mortician.
There you go.
That's what I said the first time. I thought you was trying to correct my
Mortician.
Mortician. So he is. He's doing that industry there, and that industry is busy.
The Undertaker.
They're busy. So if you're looking for a job. To dig graves and stuff like that. Holla at Pat. If you're a preacher and need to do a funeral and need to practice, so Pat probably got some that they need y'all. That's too much. No. Okay. Yeah. I'm gonna do this. Oh man, where did it go? I'm gonna do this, and we whoever asks for that song. Whoever made that question. We're gonna talk about 45 when we come back. When we come back, we're talking about 45, and I want to get his opinion on this dude here. What is really going on with this thing? Okay, we're good now. Yeah, things are really crazy in this industry. So I want you all to know, those that are in the essential, even the what's the name of it? The grocery store people and stuff like that. I've learned that a lot of people that have been dying are people that have been working in these grocery stores and stuff like that. They're the ones that have been not dying. Those are the ones that have been catching. Pat. Yo, that's Philly. That is not me. That is that's Philly. That's not me.
That should have been when you had the horn, like.
Yo, that's Philly. Y'all, after this song, we gotta come back and we gotta have a conversation about 45 and the stupidity that he has going on. Holla at your boy.
Agent Orange, 45.
Bye. You know.
Drums, please.
The groove slightly transformed, just a bit of a break from the norm, just a little something to break the monotony of all that hardcore dance that has gotten to be a little bit out of control. It's cool to dance, but what about a groove that soothes and moves romance? Give me a soft, subtle mix, and if it ain't broke, then don't try to fix it. And think of the summers of the past, adjust the bass and let the alpine blast. Pop in my CD and let me run a rhyme, and put your car on cruise and lay back, cause it's summertime. Buzz, but back then I didn't really know what it was. But now I see what happened is the way that people respond to summer madness. The weather is hot and girls are dressing less and checking out the fellas to tell them who's best. Riding around in your Jeep or your Benzos, or in your Nissan sitting on Lorenzo's. Back in Philly we be out in the park, a place called the Plateau is where everybody go. Guys out hunting and girls doing likewise, honking at the honey in front of you with the light eyes. She turn around to see what you beeping at. It's like the summer's a natural aphrodisiac, and with a pen and pad I compose this rhyme to hip you and to get you equipped for the summertime. Short set. Yeah, I got on sneaks, but I need a new pair, cause basketball courts in the summer got girls there. The temperature's about 88,
hop in the water plug, just for old time's sake. Break to your crib, change your clothes once more, cause you're invited to a barbecue to start at four. Sitting with your friends, as y'all reminisce about the days growing up and the first person you kiss. And as I think back, makes me wonder how the smell from a grill can spark off nostalgia. All the kids playing out front, little boys messing around with the girls playing double dutch, while the DJ spinning a tune as the old folks dance at your family reunion. Then 6 o'clock rolls around, you just finished wiping your car down. It's time to cruise, so you go to the summertime hangout. It looks like a car show. Everybody come looking real fine, fresh from the barbershop, applied from the beauty salon. Every moment frontin' and maxin', chillin' in the car, they spend all day waxin', leanin' to the side, but you can't speed through, 2 miles an hour, so everybody sees you. There's an air of love and of happiness, and this is the Fresh Prince's new definition of summer madness.
You're listening to Life After the Collar with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do. I got my boy Philly in the house today. We're having a good time tonight, man. We actually only have about 7 minutes, but I think I'm going to let it roll on until Philly's ready to get out of here.
7 minutes?
We went through the show, man.
Talk about shit.
Well, we're getting ready to do on 45 right now. You call him Agent Orange. The question was, I don't know if that was, I think that was Michelle, asked, what, how the hell you know, you must follow, oh Lord, not, that was Jackie talking, it was up for, she ain't do nothing, man, she ain't do nothing, man,
she was talking to you?
Yes,
okay.
See, that right there, they asked, what do you think of 45? Agent Orange. Honestly, seriously. Because I know you're going to be real with it. And you're going to give, I think, your mind is so, one of the things I love, the reason why I love talking to Philly, his mind is deep. So, when there was certain conversations that we've had in the cigar lounge, that I knew he was going to take this position. I knew Philly was going to take this position, and he took the totally opposite, and it floored me. So he doesn't go with the status quo. He go with his honest feelings, his honest thoughts. So I'm going to ask you straight up. What are your thoughts on 45, good and bad? Because I have good and bad with 45. Mostly bad, but I have good and bad with 45. My number one thing, and I'm turning over to you after I say this, my number one thing with 45, he's the only real dude in D.C. He's the only real person. He's showing y'all, this is who I am.
You know what you're getting with
him. That part right there.
You know what you're getting with him.
And that's why
You ain't got to try to figure it out. He ain't going to sugarcoat it. He going to say what he want, how he feel, when he want to.
That's what I love about 45. His ability, not, I don't call it his ability, his disability, but his he's like this. This is how I am. I'm stupid, and I'm going to let y'all know that I'm stupid, and ain't nothing y'all can do about it. And he say it to your face.
But I wouldn't even say stupid.
What word would you use?
I just believe that he just honestly believes what he says.
Period. That's it right there.
So, I mean, you can't fault somebody for believing what, you know, like. So, he got a few tied to him to make him dance and jump. But he gonna do what he wants.
Period.
When he wants to do it. You know, like I said, some of the shit he say is, you know, is you know, is borderline racist, is borderline, you know, anti-Semitic. But you know what you're getting when you talk to him.
Let me. I'm gonna stay in the same area of politics. But y'all know the election is coming up. Did you hear the Breakfast Club this morning?
Did you hear what Joe Biden said?
Yes, that's where I'm going with it. So you heard what he said?
I didn't hear it, but I read it in verbatim.
I heard him.
Listen, I've been using a lot of big fucking words tonight, dog. Like, I don't know what's in his Dos Equis.
he got. Look, see, that's why I didn't mind my boy coming in the studio, because I know that when he speaks, it's not just nonsense stuff. He's gonna be. His words are gonna. Your words make sense, and you don't use simple words like 45. 45 said great a lot. It's gonna be wonderful.
Yeah.
It's gonna be really, really great.
It's really good.
But you know, and so that's why I'm digging this conversation. So
I just bought some disinfectant in the straw too. So I'm just, if you need some to help battle that corona thing, just let me know. And I cut it with bleach, so we should be great, wonderful. And amazingly good.
That's what we're doing tonight. That's what we're doing tonight. His okay, back on topic. If y'all didn't, it was on topic. Because y'all know 45 told y'all to go drink, put some bleach in the syringe and inject yourself. Or drink y'all a cup of Fabuloso. And y'all gonna be, you know, spray the Lysol around your mouth and nose and inhale it. Put it in, spray it in the bag, inhale it. That's what 45 told you. And then now he's promoting this drug. And y'all know that man ain't taking that drug, right? Y'all do know that.
He couldn't pronounce the drug.
So you know this man is not taking a drug.
It's a lot of shit. It's a lot of drugs out there I can't pronounce.
No, yeah, because I'm on a whole bunch of drugs upstairs that I
can. Is not for radio. You shouldn't say that out loud.
It was prescribed by a doctor. Except for the weed.
Lead with that. I have a lot of prescribed drugs up there that I take.
I should have used the word prescribed.
You should have led with that. Prescribed first, but not, I'm on a whole lot of drugs upstairs. Like, we having a whole drug party over here or something. No.
Okay.
You know it's cops out there that watch this shit?
I wish y'all would come into my, knocking on my door.
They don't knock when they come.
Look, okay, you bust through my door. I shoot. If I die, I tell people all the time, if I die, I'm taking somebody with me.
The goal is to not die.
Yeah, but if you come in shooting, I'm shooting back. That's what I want to talk to you about, too.
Kentucky, right?
Yes, but I want to finish this, though.
Okay.
So check this out. If y'all didn't hear what Biden said, if y'all need to go back and check out the Breakfast Club this morning.
Speaking of the Breakfast Club, did you see Charlamagne the God looking like a whole damn, like,
boy, Don't do it. Okay. Don't do it. Don't do it.
He made Prince look.
How did I know you was going to say that? Yeah, okay.
So Joe Biden.
Mm-hmm. Joe Biden
said, if you got to choose between me and Donald Trump,
and you don't
you
know
ain't black.
Yeah, if you don't know who to choose between me and Donald Trump, then you ain't black. He told this to Charlamagne on the Breakfast Club this morning.
I mean, Charlamagne ain't black no more. I mean,
you can't say that. He's evolving.
He got that Sammy Sosa.
No, he's evolving, man.
What Mike say it was? He got like alopecia.
Don't do that. Don't do that. Don't do that, man. Don't do that. Don't do that to him. Charlamagne was interviewing Biden, and the question came up about Charlamagne had made a statement. Well, I don't know who to, something to point. You know, what makes you think I should vote for you over Trump? And Biden said, basically said, if you don't know to vote for me over Trump, then you're not black.
this is why I don't like Biden. Biden takes his foot and he shoves it up his butt and then he sticks it in his mouth. That's as plain as I... That's as
scientifically, the human body can't do
that. Well, he finds a way to do it. That's my point right there. He finds a way to stick his foot in his butt and then turn it around and stick it in his mouth. That's why I told y'all from the beginning, I have never been a Biden fan. Now, I'm stuck in this situation of choosing the... Not, I can't even call it lesser of two evils.
Best of the worst.
The best of the worst. This issue that we dealing with, I've said on my show before, this issue that we deal with concerning the jail, the prison system, and the legal system and stuff that we're dealing with, that stuff is because of Biden, of a law that he brought to the Senate to pass. And now he's trying to backtrack on that.
He's just doing what all politicians do.
That part right there. That's the problem. I'm gonna go ahead and say it. That's the problem I have with Obama. Obama was in a position to correct or expose, if not correct, at least expose.
Couldn't.
But them strings that was attached to him
couldn't
would not allow him to.
He didn't have a house behind him.
The first year he did. The first term he did. It wasn't until the second term that when he lost the Senate that everything went awry.
Are you positive about that?
Yes.
Okay.
They lost. But that's why even when it comes to Republicans and Democrats, it's not a Republican-Democrat thing. Back then, it wasn't a prop. I don't know how much it is now, but back then, it was a white folks started, and even now, it's even more pressure. White folks are realizing that they're losing their power. That's why the immigration is so big now. They don't want more immigrants to come in because now whites are becoming the new minority, and they don't like that. All of their power that they once had, when all of these women got into office and now all of these different ethnicities got into office and they lost the white man, women and people of color has hindered the white man's power hold that they've had. They no longer have that. And so they're doing whatever it takes. That's why they bagged this. That's why they bagged this dude. And they make themselves, and they reveal to us who they really are. It's not about the people. I believe, it depends on who the vice president comes into play. This is me. He said he's going to get a woman.
I believe it's Stacey Abrams.
I believe it's Stacey Abrams too. If that happens, a whole lot of stuff is going to, because I believe, I met Stacey Abrams. I was able to sit down and talk to Stacey Abrams and stuff like that. I honestly believe that her heart is pure in this, in the politics and wanting to have a better nation. Here's the problem. If you get up there in the White House, you're going to have to uncover a whole bunch of stuff that's going on in there. For instance, I'm going to tell y'all one of the things that I know for a fact. I was in, I was stationed, had to deploy to Afghanistan, Iraq. Got out of the military and I was approached by someone that wanted me to go back over there to do security for this one particular security company.
PMC.
That is owned by Dick Cheney, the former vice president. I was going to be making six figures, 90% of it tax free. I don't have to pay for room and board. I don't have to pay for food. If you're paying me six figures and all of these other security, civilian security people, six figure, how much are you making? These are government, a lot of these government contracts are going to the politicians that's in office. That's why they should put a limit on how long you can serve in the Senate and how long you can serve in the White House. The presidency is nothing. It's them jokers in the House and the Senate. That's, you got 30 years in there. You got cats that's been serving in the White House, in the Senate, and the House for 30 years. Those are the ones that's making all the money. Because those are the ones that make all the laws. And those are the ones that say where the money goes. That's why instead of once you're in the politics and get up there in the House and the Senate, you should not be able to have a contract with the government. I ain't telling y'all what I think. I'm telling y'all what I know. I'm going to tell y'all something. I'll expose. I don't care if ain't nobody watching my page. Even if they are, I don't care. Because I'm only telling the truth. If I can't prove it, I'm lying. But I can prove it. I was in charge of what we call government credit cards, and each government credit card had like hundreds of thousands of dollars on it. I was in charge of the budget. My job was to go over budget. If I did not come under budget, I would get in trouble. Y'all know how they kid around on these movies and people talking or whatever and say they spent $500 on a hammer, $200 on a screw and a nail? They ain't lying. We waste so much of y'all tax dollars. We literally waste so much of your tax dollars so that next year I can at least, my division can at least get the same amount, if not more. I'm just telling y'all what I know. They talk about this military budget. It's a whole bunch of stuff, a whole bunch of money that we really can save on if we just do some accountability. It's just like that Ben Carson bought $10,000 chairs, $45,000 table or something like that, whatever the prices was on there. I know I'm misquoting it. I don't know how I got off on that, but it is what it is. I'm going to do this because I'm tired of hearing Philly music.
You should have went right into Jay-Z's song, Politics as Usual. Mm-mm. Play Friday by Sir Charles.
You know what? That would have been a good one if he would have told me that earlier. I got it somewhere.
Because this show ain't fun no more. I'm about to head out.
The president is the puppet for the Senate and the Congress. That's taught in school. Not in this day and age. It used to be. But not in this day and age.
It's grown men.
East Coast, West Coast, and Midwest?
Mm-hmm. Yep, all three of them. What about the Dirty South? You forgot them.
I bet.
Come on, man.
I don't know what... Here's what we're going to do, y'all. We're gonna go into a musical break, and then after we do that, we are going to... I'm gonna say goodbye. What? How much time I got?
Until you log off. You got an allotted amount of time?
I got 3 hours, but I ain't doing 3 hours.
No, you ain't gotta do 3 hours. I ain't staying 3 hours. Chill. Hell, I look like.
We all.
I got things to see and people to do.
Say that again?
I got things to do and people to see. Yeah.
You said it right the first time.
Yeah. Yeah.
My thing is not acting right. That's why I'm procrastinating.
You should have had that shit queued up.
I did. I thought I did.
Yeah.
So how y'all doing, man? Everybody alright?
Why you? Somebody said, why you? Oh, Jackie said, why you shaking your head, Chuck?
Because I like the way my beard flows when I shake it.
We ain't even doing that. Holler at your boy. It's all good. It's all great.
We gonna start this thing all right. Duval in the money logging. How come on? How come on? Do it, baby. Take it, baby. Do it, baby. Take it, baby. Do it, baby. Take it, baby. Do it, baby. I'm living my best life.
To be smiling for. So what the f you be wildin' for? Come on, I get my grin on. I'm smiling, bitch, cause I always get my win on. I've been on so many different stages. Graced the cover of 100 magazine pages. Made people smile everywhere that I went. I even put it on the first black president. It's evident I'm hot as a crock pot. With a big ass smile like Mr. Hotspot. You got a lot to be smiling for. So what the f*** you be wildin' for? If you're breathing, you achieving. We having fun this evening, believe it.
Up in the air and show a hater you don't even much care. We finna get another bag this year. My ex, you can have that there. Hey, this year bad vibes get cut off. More trips, new chicks with no draws. More drinks, more smoking, more cars. More shows with Duval and Snoop Dogg. Look, I ain't tryna throw no shade, cause I can't see them in my lane. As long as my rent getting paid, I can care less with a beer bank, huh? You in the club every night with no job. Smile, smile, eating good off your food stamp card. Smile, smile, you made a killing last year off fraud. Smile, if you know you ain't going to work tomorrow.
Smile, smile, smile. I'm living my best life.
A lot to be smiling for. So what the f you be wildin' for? If you're breathing, you achieving. We having fun this evening, believe it.
You're listening to Life After the Collar with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do.
You ain't even do the
I-holler. That's my, I got to do, you told, first of all, what did you tell me on the last show?
Don't ever do that fucking voice again. Ever. No, it wasn't that one. It was like the Yeah, don't.
That one right there. See, y'all, look, this is, you know.
Chuck the Deuce is up to something. But just do a mic drop. You ain't even got to do a mic drop. Just hit it real hard and then walk away. Just leave.
Is that right? Mm-hmm. Y'all, I appreciate y'all hanging out with me today.
There's a lot of people talking. Still on?
Yeah, you got people over here. You got people over here.
I can't see. I'm blind in my left eye. I can't see on my right. So,
yo, I appreciate y'all hanging out with me tonight. We talked about something, anything, and everything. I was going to talk about. It was something that I wanted to ask you earlier. I forgot what it was now, though. You want to ask me something? Never mind.
Do I want to ask you something?
Nope.
Nope.
We cool. Yep. Y'all make sure y'all have a good Memorial Day weekend. Please understand what Memorial Day is about.
Right.
Do not send me a text.
Happy Memorial Day.
Do not.
He's still alive. Dumbass.
I'm right here. Y'all see that? I'm breathing. I'm still here. Memorial Day is for those that served in the military that has passed away already. They got to be dead. We're celebrating them.
No more. That's it.
Those are the people that we're celebrating. Do not send me a text talking about Happy Memorial Day. Please don't.
That's for Veterans Day.
Thank you.
In November. You got Thank 6 you. Months to get your text right.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Because it's May. That's 5 plus 5.
Yeah. Well, you know your math. Yeah. Y'all, let me tell y'all something about playing dominoes with this dude here.
Don't do it.
So he gets mad at me. Because what do I do? Because
you need to take off your shoes and count with your toes.
I count every dot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I count every dot.
And still count them wrong.
No, it's not that I call them wrong. I count my points. Because you only get 30, 25. You count by 5. So I say what I'm going to get. But they, the way these hard nose are.
I don't play that way. I just play that way with them. Pause.
I'm like, just call what you got. I'm not going to give you 27 points. I'm going to give you 25. Give me 25. I'm like that.
But you still count it wrong.
Well, just give me my 25. You take the other 5.
Mm-hmm. How about I just take all 30?
Steady wrong. What they say?
Long,
steady wrong. Wrong.
Oh, you said you wanted to talk about Kentucky.
Yeah, I'm going to let you handle Kentucky.
Why?
Because that was your topic.
That wasn't my topic.
Okay, well, let's go before we go. Okay, what you want to talk about, Kentucky?
He should have shot every one of them motherfuckers.
Period.
That's it.
Period.
And he should be home mourning the death of his wife or girlfriend or whoever she was. And they had the wrong address. Fuck them.
Because they just bombarded their way into there.
No, they kicked the door in.
That's what I said. They bombarded their way in there.
You know, having your door kicked in is not fun. Not that I know anything about
I was just trying to... I was gonna ask the question, how...
I've seen a lot of shit on TV.
Okay.
Plus, I stayed at a Holiday Inn Express last night, so... No thanks. Shout out to my brother Darren. That's his line. I stole that for a minute. Little plagiarism there, but
before I
was another big ass word that I just used. I am impressing the shit out of myself.
Look, public education up in Philly must be off the chain.
It's better than Georgia's. I'm just saying.
Cause you're using like huge words tonight.
I know what they mean too.
I appreciate that.
And I can count.
You have upgraded my show.
Nah, the show was already.
No, cause you don't. No, because you came on my show correcting my plethora.
And you just fucked it up.
What is it?
Pleth.
Plethora. Well, you know I can't even pronounce. What's the thing that doctors wear around their necks?
Stethoscope?
I can't say that word at all. Stethoscope. I promise you, I can't. I have nurses that and nurses friends of mine that try to teach me to say. I can't say that. Stethoscope.
Steth.
Stess.
So
Stacy.
Listen.
Stacy.
Like Steph Curry. Like
Steph.
You know his brother? Seth.
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 Never mind. You probably put say Paschetti too, don't you? And scrimp. And scree.
No, I know how to say street. Straight. Shrimp.
Who?
Shrimp. I did just mess that up. Shrimp. I know how to say it. I just can't say stethoscope. Hey,
no,
man.
You know, man, no matter what people say about you when you're not around, you hire with me, dog. He was like, that nigga J-Man ain't shit. I was like, he hired with me. Cool with me. I don't know what he did to you, but he hired with me.
I'm finna shut the show down. We got, I'm gonna give y'all 6 minutes.
That means 8:30.
I'm done. Let me ask you.
Go ahead, man.
So they arrested.
You've been on the show. You said 8:30.
Yeah.
I started at seven.
That's
90 minutes. So you did 84 minutes on air.
I did.
That's 6 minutes from 90.
I'm finna go to Magic City, man.
Magic City is closed.
Oh.
They got a drive-through strip club now.
They got a drive-through strip club?
I don't know. It just sounded good when I said it, though. So I went to a party. Let's have a thing. So I went to a party a few weeks ago, not too long ago, a while ago, and they had strippers there. It was a private event.
Is this a real story?
I promise you it's a real story. They had strippers there. It was two strippers. And, I mean, at this time, we was, like, at the heart of COVID. So, you know, it was like a risk even being out there. No, I'm dead serious.
No, I'm with you. Go ahead. Tell the whole story.
So, I get there. It's seven guys there, right? Seven. Two strippers. So we was under the 10, you know, the max of 10.
Okay.
Right? We was under the 10 mark.
Okay.
These two, I almost called them a whore. These two chicks literally dance for 2.5 hours with a mask and gloves on. I cannot make this up.
You lie.
Swear to.
You lie.
The heavens.
You lie.
All of them. Mask and gloves.
For 2 hours.
For 2.5 hours.
Ain't nobody passed out.
No. I mean, like, surgical masks, too. Like, one chick had, like, a special made mask that said Jamaica or some shit on it to go with her Jamaica color thong and bra shit. With black surgical gloves on. I can, listen. I can make a phone call to confirm this story.
Philly, you lying.
I am dead serious. They danced for 2.5 hours with a mask and gloves on.
How many quarters they come away with?
I don't know. I was shooting pool. You not dancing, baby? Nope. Social distancing.
Complete social distancing. I'm just here to play pool.
Keep your dirty ass 6 feet away.
I'm not with Philly, y'all. I'm not. Hey, y'all, thank y'all so much for hanging out with me tonight. I got my boy in the house, Philly, hanging out with me tonight. We're going to have him back because it looks like y'all love Philly being on the show. So we're going to have Philly back on the show. Holler at your boy.
Follow me at www.itookyourchicktowafflehouselastnight.com.
I can't stand.
My other page is ladies, ub6ib9.com.
So, I tried to tell y'all it was going to be one of them nights. I really did try to tell y'all it's going to be one of them nights.
I ain't even had nothing to drink. Imagine if I had some scotch in me. Woo.
I don't smoke in the house. Woo. But imagine if we was, because I'm going to do something. When I finish the patio down in the backyard and I set up, call. Man, I appreciate you, Doc. I appreciate you having your brother hook me up and all of that stuff.
You know, I especially like that one part in that song.
What one part? Oh.
You took your baby mama out or took your baby mama home. I think that's how it go. That's one of the lyrics.
Let me play the song. I was finna play my song, but let me go ahead and show y'all. I'm gonna play the first part of the song, which y'all getting ready to hear, is the new intro to Life After the Collar. My boy 7 Mil out of New Orleans hooked me up with this jam.
Did you see my Facebook post earlier?
Ooh wee. Should I have?
I'm just wondering if you did.
No, I depend on.
Places that you can't pronounce.
Yes, I saw that.
That's all I want to do. I just want to have fun with somebody else's chick.
Thank y'all so much for hanging out with me tonight on on Life After the Collar. I'll see y'all Monday. I'll let you boy. It's all good. It's all gravy. This is the new intro song plus the actual song. So the intro is the intro to my show. However, it is a real song that's out. 7 Mil out of New Orleans. See, this is why. That's this. See, I'll let your boy. It's all good. It's all gravy.
I'll let your boy. Life After the Collar with J Man. You heard me? We out here on all social media platforms. So if you look good. And if you smell good.